Hello everyone, today we'll see the break. I am Sachin Rathod, working as an assistant professor in mechanical engineering department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So the learning outcome of this session is student will able to understand working of single block or shoe brake. So generally the brakes is a device which is used to bring to rest a body which is in the motion or to hold the body in the state of rest or of uniform motion against a action of external force. Means if any kind of the rotating system is there, so we can stop by using the brake. So brake is a very important terms in a mechanical engineering. So the types of brake, first one, the hydraulic brake. So hydraulic brakes we will observe in pump or hydrodynamic brake and fluid agitator. So generally the hydraulic energy is used to stop the rotating system. So for that case we can call hydraulic brake. Second type is electric brake. So in that we will observe the examples of generators and eddy current brake. So electric energy we are using for stopping the rotating system. And the third one is mechanical brake. So the mechanical brakes in which the mechanical energy we are using for stopping the rotating system. So generally if we can take the consideration of the any systems like our the car brake is a example of mechanical brake. So in that the classification of mechanical brakes. So first one is single block or shoe brake, second one simple band brake, third one differential band brake, fourth one band and block brake, and fifth one internal expanding brake. So we'll see all these five types one by one. So first one, single block or shoe brake. So this is a schematic diagram of single block or shoe brake, in which one lever is there which is pivoted at point O, that is called as a fulcrum O, and on that lever the shoe or the block is mounted rigidly and our rotating wheel is there, that is also called as a drum. So when the drum will get rotated in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction, at that times when we want to stop the rotating wheel, we are apply the force at one end of the lever by an amount of P in a downward direction, then there is a friction will occurs in between block and the wheel get stopped. So this is a working of single block or shoe brake. So you can think about this, what are the applications of shoe brake. So generally the shoe brakes we will observe in case of our the bicycle brake, or we can see the train wheel for stopping the train, on that the train wheels we are using the shoe brake. So this is a bicycle brakes. So such kind of the brake is called as single block or shoe brake. So we will see what is the working of this single block or shoe brake. This is a rotating drum on which when we are applying the force of this shoe, and this shoe is attached by using the lever. It is pivoted at point O. It is also called as a fulcrum. This is a lever end on which we are applying the force P in the downward direction. Suppose the length of the lever is L and the center of this wheel, the distance from fulcrum to the center of the wheel is A. This is a block which is rigidly fixed to this lever. When we are applying the force P in the downward direction at one end of the lever, then there is a friction occurs between this rotating wheel and this block. The angle of these blocks is 2 theta and r is the radius of this wheel. This is a wheel or drum. This is our lever. So we will see how the forces are acting on this wheel. So if suppose the wheel is rotating in clockwise direction, so at that time the normal reactions from this block to the wheel is acting in a downward directions, and the frictional force, if it is rotated in the clockwise direction, the frictional force will act like this. So this is our the normal reaction Rm on the wheel, and the frictional force F is equal to mu Rm. So this is a free body diagram of wheel. So whatever the friction will occurs, that occurs on this block or the shoe, because the material of the shoe or the block is softer than that of the wheel. So we'll draw the free body diagram of block. This is our the block, and here the our lever is there. So on this block, as on the wheel, the normal reaction is acting vertically downward direction. So the normal reactions occurs on the block or the shoe, it is acting in a upward direction Rm, and the frictional force is opposite of this frictional force, it is acting in this direction, that is a F is equal to mu Rn. So like this forces are acting on this block. So we have to calculate the value of Rn, because whatever the amount of the friction will occurs, that will occurs on this block. So for designing purpose, we should know how much amount of the friction will occurs. So for finding the value of TB, TB is nothing but the braking torque. So the braking torque is nothing but the frictional force F into radius of wheel, and this frictional force F is equal to mu Rn into the R. Therefore TB is equal to mu Rn into the radius of the wheel. So by using this equation, we can easily calculate the value of braking torque. So here the important term is Rn. So our task is to calculate the value of normal reaction Rn. So for calculating the normal reaction, there are two cases. So first one, your the drum will get rotated in the clockwise direction, or your drum will get rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. So respective to that, our the direction of frictional force will acting in this direction or in this direction. So we'll see that in the next session. And the second thing is that the position of fulcrum. So in this case, the position of the fulcrum, it may lie along the line of the friction. So this is a line of the friction, frictional lining force. So this is a frictional lining force. So if the drum will get rotated in the clockwise direction, the frictional force will act in that direction, and if your the drum will get rotated in the anti-clockwise direction, the frictional force acts in this direction. So the position of the fulcrum, it may be the lie along the line of the action of the frictional force at these positions, or the fulcrum O, it is acting below the line of the action of the frictional force by an amount A, or the position of the fulcrum is acting at this position, that is a above the distance from the line of the frictional force. So these cases also we have to see in the next session. So these are my references. Thank you.